Sulfur for acne and acne scars is a great solution because of its numerous skincare properties. And if you remember hearing sulfur in science class, well, I'm here to tell you its applications can also be used in skincare when it comes to treating acne. From treating acne to helping fade acne scars, sulfur is a hidden gem when it comes to trying to get rid of acne fast and tackling down acne scars. And in this video, we'll go over how sulfur works in acne, what types of acne can it treat, how can it work for acne scars, as well as going over how to use it if you're using a sulfur soap, a sulfur clay mask, or as a sulfur spot treatment. All of this is going to be covered, so you don't want to miss this. Stay tuned till the end of the video. Hi guys, you've seen Arsalan, media pharmacist here on YouTube. This channel is all about helping you make more informed decisions about your health and wellness. And if that's something you're into, take 2 seconds now to give this video a like to support my channel and subscribe down below to not miss out on future videos. But really giving it a like is more than enough to make my day. Let's first look at how sulfur can help acne. You see, acne flares up when a combination of bacteria, sebum, and skin cells become trapped in hair follicles leading up to inflammation. Now sulfur, remember, it's a naturally occurring amino-rich mineral that's found normally already in our hair, skin, and nails. But what about it makes it so special? Well, it contains antimicrobial and anti-inflammatory properties to reduce one major culprit, Cutibacterium acnes. The bacteria known to cause acne. And on top of that, sulfur is keratolytic, which means that it causes the area around the acne to dry and peel, effectively exfoliating the area, which can help cool down the acne and unclog blocked pores, allowing a fresh layer of healthier new skin to grow in that same spot. Not only does it have anti-inflammatory, antimicrobial, and keratolytic properties, sulfur is also bacteriostatic, which helps prevent new pimples from developing in that area. So really think of it as instead of destroying the bacteria, it stops it from multiplying to cause newer pimples to form. But what kind of acne should I be using it is the biggest question here. And to put it simple, sulfur is most effective for mild acne because it's not strong enough to tackle down the deeper forms of acne. So if you're one to not necessarily break out with full-blown cystic acne and maybe get the occasional white or blackhead like me, sulfur is going to work best here because it targets both the oil buildup and the extra skin cells that cause these comedones. But what about for pustules and papules though? That's a good question because these forms of acne are known as moderate acne, which are still forms of inflammatory acne that cause red lesions to appear. You can still use sulfur here, but not alone. I would use it in combination with other acne-fighting ingredients such as sodium sulfacetamide so you could tackle the issue from all angles. Also guys, if you are enjoying the video, give it a like down below real quick. Now let's get right back to the video. The big question, which is what you guys want to know, what about for acne scars? Sulfur works for very light scarring because it dries out the skin and removes the extra skin cells. It is thought that it could even help to even out the skin through its exfoliating nature after the acne has cleared. However, most acne scars that are deeper will require much more intense treatments such as salicylic acid and topical retinoids. So I wouldn't entirely rely on sulfur to do the heavy lifting here. I'd reserve it only for this light hyperpigmented patches that you appear after a pimple has passed. Because remember, if it's thought to even out the skin, reducing hyperpigmentation of scars by replacing passed away skin cells with new non-hyperpigmented cells that develop in the place, if the turnover is supported, then sulfur may in fact help with them. It may in fact help with light acne scars. Even though more research is needed to prove that, interestingly though, in the past, personally, I have used it on whiteheads and it has helped prevent pigmentation that I see afterwards with the whiteheads that I get, so it wouldn't hurt to try. And lastly, let's take a look at how to use it correctly, because remember, lots of products use sulfur, but let's go through 3 of the most common options: foaming sulfur soap, sulfur clay masks, and sulfur spot treatments. Which, by the way, the sulfur spot treatment is one of my favorite options. And I've left all my recommendations for these 3 types of sulfur products in the description below, So definitely check that out when you get a chance. The links will all be down there. Number one, for the sulfur soap, use it if you have sensitive and oily skin types. If you have skin that is oily and are waking up with oily skin and produce more oil throughout the day, when you wash your face in the morning with the foaming sulfur soap, your morning is gonna start with less oil, and when you wash your face before sleeping, your pores will also be clearer at night. But make sure to not exceed washing your skin more than 2 times with it, as it can lead to irritations, and we don't want that at all. Also, what helps with this is to use a moisturizer afterwards to prevent overdrying of the skin as well, because sulfur can be actually pretty drying for the skin sometimes. Number two, for the sulfur clay mask, which has gained a lot of popularity, again, it's best for oilier skin types as it allows sulfur to stay longer on, and it's best to use it after you've already cleansed your face with a gentle cleanser. Make sure to avoid the eyebrows and the mouth and the eyes once the mask time is over, because this could lead to irritation if it gets into those areas. Rinse off the mask gently and try your best not to scrub the face afterwards, because it could irritate the skin as well. And number three, lastly, the sulfur spot treatment. Now, this is a different type of treatment, as it is meant to reduce the pimples that are slowly becoming more visible. If the pimple is already there, the sulfur pretty much won't help, because it's more so preventative here. However, if you're getting ready for a date or a meeting or have to present something and you want to tackle, let's say, a whitehead or a stubborn blackhead, use the sulfur spot treatment. Apply the spot treatment on the skin surface and wash it off before bedtime, but only use the spot treatment once a day, because you will dry out your skin if you keep using it throughout the day. Oh, also guys, I almost forgot to mention one thing with the sulfur is that it can have a pungent odor, which some people say that it resembles rotten eggs. And a lot of modern skincare products do a good job in masking this smell. However, some may still have that faint traces of that rotten egg smell, so don't be alarmed of this.
Do you smell it? That smell, the kind of smelly smell, the smelly smell that smells smelly.
And I recommend that before you use any new acne product, be sure to conduct a patch test on the inside of your arm to see whether you're sensitive to sulfur or other key ingredients in the product. And to end the video, sulfur treatments are generally safe to use, but keep in mind they are not the best option for everyone. So make sure you work with your dermatologist or esthetician to find the best treatments and the best regimens for your unique skin, because it can be easily frustrating when you try a bunch of different products and none of them seem to work. If that's you right now, consult with a dermatologist to see how you can get over that plateau. I really hope that this video was helpful. Give it a like so I know you enjoyed the video. This tells YouTube to show the video to more people. Subscribe to the channel and turn the bell on to stay updated with all future videos. And until then, guys, I'll see you on the next one.